In this very short tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make wireframe rendering of your project. I'm going to use post-process volume, and inside post-process volume we have post-process material. If you don't have post-process volume, you can create it using place actors, for example. Select post-process volume and paste it in the scene, drag and drop in the project. And next step, you need to activate infinite extent, this checkbox. So I have my main post-process volume, and let's check for infinite extent. Yes, this checkbox is activated. Next step, you need to find rendering feature stop. Let's open it, and we have post-process material. You need to press this plus button. And you can add in this field your post-process material, and inside post-process material you can create a wireframe shader. So let's do this. Let's create a material. Press right mouse button, choose material. Let's call this PPV, post-process volume. And if you want to enable post-process features of this material, you need to go to material domain and choose post-process. We have only emissive color, and this will be enough for my purposes. Next step, I'm going to create a few important nodes, scene texel size, scene depth, and screen position. Let's do it. Scene texel size expressions allows you to offset by texel size. Scene depth expression outputs existing scene depth. And screen position expression outputs the screen space position of the pixel currently being rendered. Okay, let's create multiply node. Just hold M and press left mouse button. I'm going to create a simple setup. If you want to add node, just hold A and press left mouse button. And I'm going to create setup like this. Also, I need mask node, component mask. I'm going to use only red and green channels of this guy. And let's connect like this. So my simple setup is ready, and next step I'm going to copy this branch 4 times. Just Ctrl C, Ctrl V. And next step I'm going to create a simple preset, blur sample offset. And we have inside this node a bunch of preset. This is a simple vector 2 nodes. With values 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, minus 1, minus 1, 0. And I'm going to connect these expressions for my multiply nodes. For now, we have this very simple script. And next step, I'm going to add these guys. So next step, I'm going to copy and paste another branch. For this multiply node, I'm going to multiply by 0. And let's create multiply, hold M, and multiply by minus 4, for example. And next step, I'm going to add this guy and this guy, this big branch. Using add node, and we can connect and check the result. So we get wireframe shader. Just press save and apply, and let's enable this shader inside my rendering feature tab. I'm going to press on this known node and find my PPV master material. This one, and I got this beautiful wireframe rendering. Let's activate a level sequence. For example, and we have a result in the viewport. If you want to add color randomization for this simple shader, we need to create vector 3 constant, just hold 3 and press left mouse button, choose color, and you need to multiply this guy into your expression and add this guy to your emissive color. Let's go to movie render queue, and I'm going to set up rendering of my project. Let's press to unsave it config. You can render in EXR, for example, if you want to make some post-processing. I don't need to do this, so let's create game overrides for beautiful cinematic setup. Let's add anti-aliasing because we have a big motion blur in this project. For big motion blur, I recommend 32 or maybe 64 samples. And press accept. Also, you can select your output folder. Change resolution, for example, 4K. Change file name, press accept, and press render local. And in this window, you can find your result. This is wireframe rendering using post-process material inside post-process volume. Thanks for watching.